Well, tonight, a look at the shifting gears of our car culture.
By the end of the year, some driverless cars will be on the highway. So which companies are racing to put their models to the test? And are we ready?
That's the question. Our Natasha Brown shows you what it takes to go hands-free.
Say in mode.
Hold on. This is happening and fast.
Oh, my God!
The future is near. What once seemed like something out of a science fiction movie far into the future could become reality very soon. Manufacturers are putting the pedal to the metal on developing fully autonomous or self-driving cars.
There are roughly 20 different automakers that are saying by 2020, they'll have fully autonomous vehicles in the market.
From Ford to Toyota, and the list goes on.
When you talk about real autonomy, it's about taking your hands off the wheel and being able to focus on other things inside the car.
That's different from a semi-autonomous car that needs a driver, but the car can brake for you and change lanes like Tesla's autopilot feature. Tesla did hit a road bump when a driver was killed using autopilot.
If autonomous cars aren't done right, they may introduce new forms of fatalities that could replace the old and may be unnecessary.
According to the National Safety Council, up to 40,000 people die in car crashes yearly.
PennDOT statistics show that in 2015, Pennsylvania saw the second lowest number of traffic fatalities on record with 1,200. And local experts say fully autonomous cars could go a long way in lowering that number even more.
We have a long way to go to understand how safety will look for them.
Alex Quistberg is an associate research professor at Drexel University. He sees the initial safety benefits with sensors on autonomous cars reducing human error.
If we think about the major causes of road fatalities in the United States, that's speeding, distraction, alcohol, or drug-induced driving. Those are all things that could potentially be reduced by having a fully autonomous vehicle.
While some may be hesitant to embrace the new technology, it's not slowing the development process. Uber is working on a driverless car with Ford. DMVs around the country are working on regulations, as we may see driverless cars on the roads by the end of the year.
You're going to be able to do anything you do in your living room in your car, and the vehicle is going to take you from point A to point B,
giving you the freedom to just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. Natasha Brown, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
Did she say relax?
Yeah, right. Let it go.
Not going to be able to do it.